Well, you know, the you have chosen a somewhat difficult case, you know, because the one of the most difficult types is the intuitive introvert.
Yes,
you know.
Yes.
The intuitive extrovert you find among hunters, bankers,
yes,
gamblers.
Yes, yes, yes.
That is quite understandable.
Yes.
But the introvert is the introverted variety is more difficult because he has intuitions as to the subjective factor, namely the inner world.
Yes.
And of course that is now very difficult to understand. Because what he sees are most uncommon things. And he doesn't like to talk of them.
Yes.
If he's not a fool. Because he would spoil his own game by telling what he sees. Because people won't understand it.
Yes.
For instance, once I had a patient, a young woman, about 27 or 28, and her first words were, when I had seated her, she said, "You know, doctor, I come to you because I have a snake in my abdomen." Hmm. I said, "What?" Yes, a snake, a black snake, coiled up right in the bottom of my abdomen. And I must have made a rather bewildered face at her. And she said, "You know, I don't mean it literally, but I should say it was a snake. It was a snake." Now, you see, our further conversation a little later was that she said, that was about in the middle of our treatment, that only lasted for 10 consultations. She had foretold me, "I come 10 times and then it's all right." I said, "How do you know?" "Oh, I got a hunch," she said.
Yeah.
And really, about the fifth or sixth hour, she said, "Doctor, I must tell you, the snake has risen. It is now about here." Hunch. And then, on the 10th day, I said, "Now, this is our last hour. And do you feel cured?" And she said, beaming, she said, "You know, this morning, it came up and came out of my mouth and the head was golden." Mm. And those were her last words. Mm. Now, you see, that same girl, when it comes to reality, she came to me because she couldn't hear the step of her feet anymore.
Yes.
Because she walked on air.
Yes.
Literally.
Yes.
She couldn't hear it, and that frightened her. And then she came to me, asked her for her address. And then she said, "Oh, pension so-and-so. Well, it is not just called pension, but it is a sort of pension. And it is, I never had heard of it."
Yes.
And now, I'm curious, I never have heard of that place. "Well, it's a very nice place," he said. Curious enough, there are only young girls there, very nice and very lively young girls. And they have a merry time. I often wish they would invite me to their merry evenings. And I said, "But do they amuse themselves all alone?" Said, "Oh no, there are plenty of young gentlemen coming in, and they have a beautiful time, but they never invite me." It turned out that it was a private brother.
Yes.
And she was a perfectly decent girl, you know, of a very good family. Not from here. She had found that place, I don't know how. And she was utterly unaware that those were all prostitutes. I said, "For heaven's sake, you fell into a very dark place. You hastened to get out of it." You see, that was her sensation.
Yes,
see, she didn't see reality.
Yes.
But she had hunches like anything, and they came off.
Yes.
Now, you see, such a person cannot possibly speak of her experiences.
Yes.
Because everybody would think she's absolutely crazy.
Yes.
I myself was quite shocked when I thought, for heaven's sake, is that case a schizophrenia?
Yes. Yes.
Because you don't hear that kind of speech.
Right.
But she assumed that the old man, of course, knows everything, and he even does understands such kind of language.
Yes.
So you see, if when the intuitive introverted intuitive
yes.
Would speak what he really perceives, then practically nobody would understand it. He would be misunderstood. And so they learn to keep things to themselves. And you hardly ever hear them talking of these things. That is the greatest advantage. But it is an enormous advantage in another way. Not to speak of the experience they gather in that respect, but also in human relations. For instance, they come into the presence of somebody they don't know, and certainly they have inner images. And those inner images give them a more or less complete information about the psychology of the partner.
Yes.
You know, that is, but the case can also happen that they come into the presence of somebody whom they don't know at all, not from Adam, and they know an important piece out of the biography of that person.
Yes, yes.
And are not aware of it. And tell the story.
Yes.
And then the fat is in the fire.
Yes, that's right.
You see? So the introverted intuitive is has it in a way a very difficult life, although one of the most interesting lives.
Yes.
But it is difficult often to get into their confidence. It's just a sort of a skeleton, to which you have to add the flesh. Or say, it is a country mapped out, you know, by triangulation points. And that doesn't mean the country consists of triangulation points.
Yeah.
That is only in order to have an idea of the distances.
Yes.
And so it is a means to an end. It only makes sense such a scheme when you deal with practical cases. Well, I told you that case of that intuitive girl.
Yeah,
Who suddenly came out with the statement that she had a black snake in the bed.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, now that is a collective symbol.
Yeah,
that is not an individual fantasy. That is a collective fantasy.
That is
well known in India.
Yeah.
Well, she has nothing to do with India, but we have it too, because it's generally human.
Yeah.
But it's entirely unknown. So that I even in the first moment thought, perhaps she's crazy.
Yeah.
But she was only highly intuitive.
Yeah.
It is in India known, it is the basis of a whole philosophical system of tantrism.
Yeah.
This is Kundalini. Yeah, Kundalini serpent.
I see.
You see? And that is something known to some few specialists.
Yeah.
Generally, it's not known that we have a serpent in the abdomen.
Yeah.
But that is a collective, you see, that is a collective dream,
yes.
Or a collective fantasy.
Yes.